Welcome back to the Diadarium Hangar. This is Captain Kirk. Stardate 11142021 2021. The Romulans, they have obtained new bots. They were able to get every single pre-order on the planet Earth. Something must be done. They must be stopped. The only person I know that can stop them is Mike. So Mike, I wish you good luck and engage.
Thank you, Kirk, but I'm more of a Picard guy, no offense, but we have some great weekly news and review between Masterpiece, Mainline, Legends, Transformers. We also got some Star Wars news out there. We've got a little bit of stuff going on with Super 7 and a little bit more coming up. All right, first off, what's going on at Show Z? The 52 Toys Megabox MB21 Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Leonardo. This is $37, and the 52 Toys is what I was thinking of with the Ravage from Hasbro that turns into a box. 52 Toys does these box transformers. Looks pretty cool, pretty interesting, and it's up at Show Z right now. Show Z also has their Forager Kickback from Phase Toys for $155, which is pretty much the going rate, more or less, for this figure for now, till it sells out. So, just a heads up, you need Forager, get them here, and you don't have to buy all three. You can just get him. Also, the 12-inch Lewin Resources Spike Witwicky for about $72. And the thing about this guy is that he is almost 12 inches tall, so this is back to the 12-inch G.I. Joe days. Head sculpt, shirt, pants, a boot, belt, flashlight, laser gun. All this stuff's included, and he is, you know, like $8 cheaper than normal. So, YOLO Park is coming out the gate with some colored in-hand pictures of their super-duper extra extremely high-end collectible figure that costs $2,750. This thing is super expensive, but they're revolutionizing how non-transformable figures are made with a lot of moving pistons and gears and a lot of stuff that's going on. So it is pretty cool for what it is. It's almost $3,000. This is like a used Honda. No doubt, though, it is huge. I believe it's well over 2 foot tall. And as you can see next to this lady here, how massively huge it is. But it looks pretty cool. It's interesting. And it changes the direction of how high-end collectibles go. Yet, this does not transform for almost $3,000. So we've got some pictures of X-Transbots. Zeusaurus. This is their take on Deathsaurus. And it looks pretty good. This is the Illusory Monk Digibash recolor of what X-Transbots put out. It looks amazing. He does great work. But anyway, side by side with the original Takara, with the KFC add-on feet and all that kind of stuff, the KFC, there it is. It looks pretty good. And I think this figure will be great, and it'll stand up next to this, and it'll stand up next to the other third-party options out there. We've already seen this mode, but there it is. It looks pretty good. And, you know, kind of what we've seen already, but I guess a different angle. And we got this bird, which is a big part of it, so there it goes. And it looks pretty good. A couple different options, different transformations, however you want it. We have TMNT Toys Age of Extinction Evasion Mode Optimus Prime with... Now they have color renders. This is not a prototype, it's still a render, but it's some color. It's not gray type. You can see what to expect when it's done, and it looks pretty good. Of course, this is based off the Age of Extinction Evasion Mode Optimus Prime. And it comes with the accessory, the shield, the axe, and something else, like a little clip-on chest piece there. But let's look at the alt mode. A couple things for this alt mode. You can see how big it's going to be based on the hand that's right there. You can also see how it's going to look, like, shape-wise. You can't really see all the colors and how they mix together and compare and contrast. And I kind of think you could tighten up the cab a little bit better, but still, overall, looks pretty much like I would expect. Okay, so this week has been very Robot Paradise, and Fans Toys Soundwave heavy. Now, I do want to admit that out of every review, I feel like every single review is lacking in the comparison department. So I'm going to try to hold up my own in the comparison department. So here compares some, a handful of the options out there for the Frenzy cassette. And that looks pretty interesting. Now, next up, we also have a comparison from this to the KFC version of Transistor, which makes you think, is there a better blaster on the way? We all know a better blaster is on the way. Will it be this year or next decade? And then we see this Fans Toys, Mech Fans Toys, Magic Square, New Age, Hasbro version compared. And it's a really nice picture, actually. It's kind of a lot of fun to see all these different versions of Soundwave. But I'm going to reserve all of my thoughts about this figure, especially compared to Takara, till I do my review, because I have very specific thoughts, and I think they'll just be reiterated times a thousand when I get them in hand. Here's another picture of them side by side. If you have not made your mind up yet which one you like better, I'll tell you which one I like better just in a few short weeks when I get mine. Also, we have the Firebird, the big Firebird, the Mocha, and this thing is, well, it's kind of like the RC, but it's a different take, a different design, a different color aesthetic, and guess what it transforms into? It transforms into the Batmobile! Yeah, it's not the Batmobile. It looks like the Batmobile. I'm going to pretend it's the Batmobile, so whatever you want to do, you can pretend it's whatever you want it to be. I like it to be the Batmobile. Like, if I look real hard, it's the 1989 Batmobile. And the last bit of Masterpiece news I have, I don't even think it's Masterpiece. I think I'm lying to you saying it's Masterpiece. The Takara Tomy MPG-01 Train by Shuki Alt Mode in hand image of the train. And there it is. Now, I want to tell you that from the get-go, they said the train mode had to be perfect, exact, on par with the exact train. And for that, every other mode fails. And the bot mode fails. Combined mode might be actually pretty solid. We don't know yet. So I'm looking forward to finding out that information. But $210 to get a perfect train and fails in other modes, maybe that's not the best business plan. Sliding into sort of Legends news. So it's kind of a fuzzy Legends area this week. But the Jizaya Toys is a company that makes a lot of designs. Sometimes they print them off. Sometimes they don't. But here we go. This one is their Cosmos. And it looks way better than what Hasbro did. And way better than G1. It's G1-esque, G1 adjacent, with, get this, articulation. So I think it looks good. I like what they did here. I wish they could just release this. Hey, let's do a full production run with real plastic, not 3D printed nonsense, and get it out there, put it out there for like $20. You know, how hard would that be? Produce like 3,000, 5,000. People would buy it up, put a little paint on it. It'd look great. We also have this 7-inch Lucky Cat Microcosmos, Cosmos, like Cosmos, it's Lucky Microcosmos. Anyway, CM01 Elvis Voltron set of 5. So this thing's coming out. People are talking about this. There are videos about this. Even our good friend Ben at Ben's Collectibles has reviewed this thing, says he likes it, and they turn into cubes. So just like the 52 toys, this turns into cubes, just like the new Hasbro Ravage turns into cubes. I think it looks pretty good. It works out. So getting into Legends and the New Age and all that good stuff. And they're making the Shattered Glass version of Optimus Prime. I think they announced it or hinted to it or showed some render. But this shows everything you get with it. So it looks pretty cool. Lots of accessories. Accessories that I don't think all these came with other iterations of their Optimus Prime. They're going to like beat this mold to death. Obviously, that's what they do. Every single mold is beat to death by them. But here it is in the alt mode. And yeah, shattered glass. You can see it shattered. It looks pretty good. A lot of paint, a lot of apps. This company does the best job with paint. They may even be better than Fans Toys with paint. Their paint looks so amazing. Just really brings the figure to life. Even a substandard design looks better with their paint. So this past week, the New Age Ultra Magnus has been the talk of the town. And I say it looks pretty good. And a lot of people have really been trashing the Magic Square version, which I think the Magic Square version has its fair share of problems, but I like it. Now, design-wise, I still like the design of Magic Square at the end when it's fully assembled. It has a massive level of problems in the alt mode and getting from alt to combined, or whatever you want to call it, the armored up mode. This one here I think is a lot easier. It's a simpler transformation. It makes it a lot simpler, but at the end of the day, which design do you like better? All that good stuff. Here is the alt mode for this. Now you get a true blue, decent alt mode that does not fall apart with New Age. So I will hand that to New Age 100%, and it looks very clean. I think the alt mode is vastly superior to New Age, the Magic Square, but I don't display mine in alt mode very often. And here we go with kind of a before and after, or as you combine kind of mode, kind of a showing, kind of this is how it goes together, I guess. Pretty interesting. So in Legends, we also have the Fast Pioneer KO slightly, minutely, slightly oversized version of the Magic Square Minotaur. And it's going to be the actual Motor Master coming out soon. Yes, it's only like $80, and it should be showing up to your doorsteps if you ordered it pretty soon, because I'm looking forward to getting this thing built, put on my shelf, and calling it a day. Maybe, just maybe, we'll get Constructicons in the same fashion. Quickly moving through some mainline stuff, I did a whole video on these reveals, gave my opinion, and I'm going to tell you where I was wrong, because I was wrong. But anyway, this is Soundwave, the Bumblebee movie Soundwave, and the alt mode is now, some people say it's a make fun of meme, it's a sled. So we're about to see some snow around the world, and, well, Soundwave's got you covered. He'll turn it into a sled, and you can go down the hill. Now, we also have this deluxe class Autobot Ratchet, and we haven't seen the Ironhide yet, and there's another listing for another Ironhide, the Studio Series 86, we're going to talk about later, but it's not this. It is not this at all, because this is deluxe, and the one we talk about later is the next size, the Voyager. Here we go with, okay, every single person, including myself, says Braun is the best. And I agree with myself that it's the best. So here it is. It looks good. What do you think? Here we go with Wheeljack. Now, I was wrong. I thought Wheeljack shared a lot of what Bumblebee and Cliffjumper had going on, but everyone says I'm wrong. So I guess if everyone says I'm wrong, then I'm wrong. So whatever. But it doesn't really matter because it's not my Wheeljack and I wanted a Cybertron mode. Here we go with the core class Ravage turning into a cube like 52 toys. Finally, I can say it right. 52 toys makes cubes. And so does the Voltron. And so does Hasbro. Here we go with another core class Shockwave. And it looks good. Doesn't turn into a gun. But I think people will figure out how to turn this thing into a gun, just so you can put it on whatever figure, maybe a Titan class figure, maybe a Combiner, maybe a Minotaur coming soon. And for the pure joy of just loving Transformers, collecting Transformers, enjoying the 1986 movie, we have this picture here with four of the Alicons, including the fifth Alicon that's in this Pit of Judgment set. Also, five Sharkies, Sharkticons. This is what these figures are made for, to be made and displayed in multiples, because that's how they were represented in the movie. It was kind of a marketing ploy. Let's only make five bad guys, and then everybody buy 10 of each of the five bad guys, and we'll make 20 good guys. One thing I didn't talk about is the new core class packaging, and there it is. Not happy with it. I don't like it, but I can't change it. I don't have a voice in this. So there it is. I'm just glad we can still see the product. So you can see paint apps. You can see the actual product in the figure, and you can see if the figure is still in there and not swapped by some scumbag. So this past week, I came across a sweep, not scourge, and I passed on it because the box was, well, beat to garbage, and that's probably the only reason it was still on the shelf. But I probably won't open a sweep. I have my scourge. I'm happy with it. I got an extra scourge to open, and I'd get a sweep just for fun. But this is the color variation if you're interested. Here they are side by side by side by side, and they're the same figure with just a slightly different plastic, darker plastic blue. The left is Scourge, the right is Sweep. So another image of an in-hand version of Starscream Coronation Set. This is $50. $50. In some places, $53. But here he is. He's got the extra shoulder pieces, cape, and he's got the crown. We looked at it last week, but it's a different picture now. And it's the same exact figure with $20 more worth of plastic. I don't know if I'm in on it or not. Probably not. So here we go with another Amazon Strikes again with a sellout on their exclusive. And it will be not only hard to get, but impossible to get. I bought one. I meant to get two, but I was being cheap and I only bought one. So I guess I can't open one. And here we go. It's sold out. And it's completely sold out. There are pictures of it. I linked it in one video like two, maybe 3 weeks ago. I don't remember when it was. But now they're sold out. And I was like, oh man, I better jump on another one so I can open one. But I don't really understand why this is exclusive. It should be a mainline release. Maybe there'll be a mainline with different recolors. I don't know. This has no business being an exclusive though. We got a Beast Wars Scorponok in the package. And no, this is not the G1 Scorponok. So it still looks pretty good. I remember seeing these on the shelf. I remember it. So for me, it's kind of like, yeah, it was kind of fun. I remember the whole kind of rectangular squared off packaging. Here he is in his bot mode and all that good stuff. These things are, in my opinion, for a retail, way too expensive. Like, I don't know if this is going to be the 23 price point or a little higher, but the smaller ones were 23. When they get into this box size, I think they're going to be a little higher than the $22.99. We'll find out when it hits Walmart. So I got to say that a lot of people are really excited about the Tigatron reissue. I didn't really know that underground. This is like one of the most popular Beast Wars characters. I've got my toe in Beast Wars, mostly for Masterpiece and any cheap versions of the originals I get to fill in until I get a Masterpiece. That's where I'm at with Beast Wars. So I don't really know that this is maybe a hard to find figure, or maybe it's just a beloved character that people want to get more of. Maybe that's it. But people are super excited that this thing is out. But more than that, I'm hearing that around the country, they're selling out. But in my part of in Oklahoma, they don't sell at all. They just shelf warm, peg warm, which is good for me because I'll get them on clearance. So there's a Generation Studio Series Voyager Ironhide for the 86 movie. And we're hoping that that thing turns out to be good. So this is kind of where the original, the Siege, and then moving into Earthrise, those figures, the Ironhide and the Ratchet, were big deluxe. So big that it was like, maybe they should have been Voyager. Now we're going to get it Voyager. Maybe we'll get a proper Ironhide, proper Ratchet, that looks like the G1 version. Who knows? Who knows? We can all just make up these happy thoughts and then be disappointed, or not believe it and then be surprised. So they're going to be pushing the Rise of the Beast back by almost a year to June 9th of 2023 instead of June 24th of 2022. And I've got to say that I'm not upset. It doesn't bother me because I kind of feel like this might not deliver what we want it to be. And it might actually hurt the community. So the longer we delay a possible disappointment, in my opinion, is better for the community. Once it comes out, if it disappoints, it will stumble the production of a lot of the figures and kind of confuse Hasbro on what to do and go forward. But it's a year later. I hope it's good. I really do hope it's good. But deep down, I have my reservations. So we're seeing that Hasbro will return to the New York Toy Fair in 2022. And The thing about it is that it's a big deal because Hasbro has so many properties. And Hasbro reveals so much stuff. When they go to Toy Fair, they don't go to Toy Fair to reveal four things. They go to Toy Fair to reveal entire lines. 30, 40 items for one line at a time. And they do 5, 6, 7 lines at a Toy Fair. So this says a bunch of things. They have a lot to reveal, a lot they want to put out there, and it's not going to be hush-hush, silent, and quiet like it's been lately with these online reveals. And these podcasts are extremely boring. I don't care. Put it all out there. Let me decipher it for myself from pictures and a little bit of a question and answer. But these online Zoom podcasts really do suck. Last thing I want to say is that TFCon Toronto in December is going to have Bob Skier. He's the story editor on Beast Machines, writer on Beast Machines and Transformers Prime. That's great. But I have a different thing I want to say about all this. I often wondered when Beast Machines would come back around. When will it surface that it is a property that people are interested in and care about, collect the stuff. I still see this stuff. The figures go for pennies on the dollar on eBay today. I bought a whole collection for $50. So, and I did that because I figured one day I'll be reviewing these figures just for fun. I'd like to have the vintage ones to compare to. So I wondered, when will this pick up? Or will this be a dead franchise? A dead part of Transformers history? All right, talking about some other stuff here. The rumor mill swirls for G.I. Joe Classified. I think G.I. Joe Classified is going from the biggest dud to the biggest stud quickly. But of course, quickly meaning 9 months from now when stuff starts showing up in July. But we've gotten sort of rumor confirmation of Tomax and Zaymot. We're going to be getting both of them in the same case, theoretically, along with Stalker. So take all of the rumors, and hopefully that works out. And then the next case is going to get Zarana, Dusty, and Crimson Guard. Just like my video. Just like the pictures I showed in my video. But I don't know 100% if these are 100% true and accurate. But everything else that's been rumored along this lines that measures up to this has been officially announced. And they were all in the same document. So I don't see why this would not be true. I'm looking forward to it. I'm excited about it. But somebody keeps saying, just buy one figure and then put a mirror up next to it. Okay, so getting into some Super 7. There's a few things Super 7 is doing. They are supposed to be releasing or revealing the next wave of Thundercats. Now, maybe the whole talk is they're going to actually put out the next wave they've already announced, but they might be announcing another wave. Anyway, it's still exciting. If the figures start showing up, it's as exciting as there's going to be more stuff we plan in the future. I think there's an equal level of excitement there. Hopefully something pans out, but there's more Super 7 going on right now. Over on Instagram, and yeah, I had to actually go to Instagram. Thanks, guys. I had to go to Instagram. That sucks. But anyway, Super 7 has put up on their Instagram a picture of, they're going to make the Turtle Van for the larger scale figures, and that's kind of cool. There are a lot of guesses. Is it going to cost $500 like their Thundercats Thunder Tank? Is it going to be a cheaper $250, $300 alternative? Who knows? And we don't know much, but this pick, we all guess a lot of stuff. There'll be more reveals in the next week. That's how they do it. This is a quick teaser. All the reveals come next week, and then everybody talks about it. Well, right now, there's this thing that's already revealed, and it's on Show Z right now. If you go to the Underground Arsenal, and they make this van, it looks phenomenal. I don't know if it's going to be better or worse than what Super 7 does, but I've already pre-ordered this thing because I look forward to it. And I got to say that I have not touched a single Super 7 TMNT figure, but I've decided I'm going to go ahead and pre-order their Casey Jones because NECA has actually come out and they said, Mike, we will not let you ever touch the cartoon version of Casey Jones from NECA. It's off limits to you. You'll never own it, ever. So I was like, thank you. You're going to be put in the same pocket. same pocket as that special Zartan, the exclusive Zartan. So I'm going to go ahead and go with this company, even though it's vastly more expensive, $45 instead of $50 for two figures, $45 for one. I don't even care about the other figure in the two-pack. So technically, it's cheaper for me. And maybe it's even a better figure. All right, you guys have patiently waited for the Star Wars news, so I'm gonna let you have it. The Plaque Series figures for the Galaxy Edge are going to be available on November 17th, and that includes this battle droid, some other droids, and stuff. So there it is, November 7th. If you're in on this, then you'll be really excited that day. A couple other reveals include a bunch of Ahsoka and Death Watch Mandalorian in the Black Series. So here they are. I have to say, and I'm going to put this out there, what Hasbro has done with Star Wars has made nothing at all in Star Wars feel special, and everything feel like an ocean of the same. And for that, it kills any and all fun in collecting. This Ahsoka would be exciting if it wasn't the fifth Black Series Ahsoka. And the same with the Vintage Collection, and the same with Mandalorian. If this wasn't the 11th Mandalorian figure they made in Black Series, it'd be exciting. But, it's losing its appeal. Nothing at all in Star Wars is special anymore, possibly ever again. We'd be more excited about these pictures of Fennec Shand if it wasn't that she's getting hidden behind 11 different Mandalorian figures. So, what they really do need to do is ease up a bit on remaking the exact same figure over and over and over. The Mandalorian himself, I don't even know which version you'd want. Which of the 11 versions of Mandalorian do you want? And then, of course, the Death Watch would be more exciting if you didn't already have the Mud Horn version and the two build-up packs and all that stuff coming. So, I don't want to be negative on it, but I haven't pre-ordered anything Star Wars in like months because I don't understand why I'd pre-order any of it. Lastly, the Black Series Rancor is more than halfway past the goal of 9,000. 5,097 currently. And you've got 22 days left to back this project. Now, the thing about this is they included the Gamorrean Guard. A lot of people are upset that they have five already, like I have. Three or four. I don't know how many I have. I have several already. I've got so many of these at $15 on clearance, and this is the packet. But I'm not surprised. I guarantee this is going to hit every one of the tier unlocks, and we're going to get some of these. We're going to get the Rancor Keeper. We're going to get a Dancer. Maybe we'll get Hutt's Slayer down the road. Who knows? But all that said, the first one did kind of suck. I like the packaging. In fact, love the packaging. But I think we'll unlock it all, and we'll get a lot of good stuff. So, what do you think about this week's weekly news and review? What else is going on out there that I didn't talk about? And what else are you in on? Like and subscribe. Hug your parent. Out.